Landon Huffman coming to a comfortable lead, coming out of two. He's got about eight car lengths, put it half a second over Dwayne Vincent as Chad Cole works the number two spot.
Time is running out. Vincent's got it. Cole wants it in the wall. Chevrolet puts the bumper to the 13 of Vincent. Vincent not backing down. He's in second. We got one car on the bottom.
You're looking at a shot of the mile and a half, Charlotte Motor Speedway, the mecca of motorsports, and we get ready for the next stop of the RSR, the Real Sim Racing Ice Breaker Winter Series, here from Charlotte. Alongside me, Wesley Outland, it is Michael Keaton, Dakota Ehrman on pit road, John Wesley and J.D. Webb and the production staff making it happen. We welcome you to the 2013 Wounded Warrior Project 200.
From Iraq and Afghanistan, our brave warriors are coming home, wounded. Some with wounds you can see, some with wounds you can't see. Wounded Warrior Project was created to support our men and women coming off the battlefield. Please help carry these warriors the rest of the way home. Get involved at woundedwarriorproject.org.
And again, it's the Warrior Project 200. Hope you enjoy that little intro video, as it is always great to do things for the men and women who fight for our country overseas. Michael Keaton, to have a weapon and stand at post to preserve our freedom that we love to have for today.
Yeah, it really is an honor, and I know these guys are really going to do this race justice tonight, and what better track to do it at, Wes, than at a night track like Charlotte Motor Speedway.
No doubt about it. Under the lights, the mile and a half, Charlotte Motor Speedway, ready to host the next stop for the RSR Ice Breaker Winter Series as we get ever so close to cranking them up in 2013 for the Full Throttle Cup Series, ready to go around Speed Weeks at Daytona. It should be an exciting. Joining us as always on pit road, Dakota Ehrman. Dakota Ehrman, associate producer with ETV Live Radio. And by the way, tonight's broadcast is also not only on ETVLive-eplay.net, but it's also on ETV Live Radio, powered by the HD Radio Network. Thank you to Phil Foltz and all the hardworking staff there for getting this race broadcasted on that network tonight. Dakota, Charlotte, mile and a half, great racing as always. We're looking for no exception here tonight at Charlotte Motor Speedway for the next stop for the Icebreaker Winter Series.
Tell you what, guys, I had the pleasure of coming out, sitting and actually being in a race here the other night, and 55 to 60 laps. What I was told by Chad Cole in the fuel window, Chad Cole actually coming in with a good bit of momentum, the points leader, which you guys will talk about a little bit later. I'm excited to see what he can do tonight, as he is currently second on the grid. We'll see if that changes later on. But Charlotte Motor Speedway usually is great racing. It's a lot of fun to watch. There's a few incidents from time to time, but it's what makes this track great, guys.
No doubt about it. I'll remind you that tonight's broadcast of the Icebreaker Winter Series on ETV Live Radio, powered by the HD Radio Network, is solely for the private, non-commercial use of our listening audience. Any republication, reproduction of the accounts using tonight's event without the express written consent of John Abbott with Real Sim Racing, as well as Patrick Kahai and J.D. Webb and John Wesley at ETV Live Radio and Phil Foltz with the HD Radio Network, is restricted and prohibited. Big thanks for all of our sponsors tonight, the VRC MK2 Virtual Racing Seat, and the winner is Motorsports Show, Gary Mercer Trucking, Inside Sim Racing, Fast Track Racing Series Weekly Live, ETV Live, and of course also iLeagueRace.com, the Pit Report Weekly Talk Show, ETV Live Radio, and HD Radio Network. Thank you all so much for all of those great names and sponsors helping make broadcasts happen. Michael Keaton, as qualifying is still on the racetrack here at Charlotte Motor Speedway.
Yeah, qualifying still underway so far. 24 drivers now make it 25 as Justin Wilson puts it fastest on the board with a 29.025. That 58 Chevrolet looking mighty good up front. 25 so far, Wes, have qualified, but still about 8 to 9, 10 more to go.
No doubt about it. Now, as we take a look at the iLeagueRace.com settings, standings of the results of the last weekend's event, and of course also where the points are. We also want to look at some of the logistics on this racetrack and stats presented by the Professor George Wood, and a great job he did. Track located in Concord, North Carolina, capacity seating of almost 140,000. It is owned by Bruton Smith from Speedway Motorsports Incorporated. His son Marcus Smith is the president, taking the place of Humpy Wheeler. The broke ground back in 1959. The first race was ever held in 1960. It was $1.25 million to build the track. And here's a funny story, Michael Keaton. Bruton Smith went bankrupt and even took the money and run in the first ever race at Charlotte, because back in the olden days, you had all of the... He was in the car dealership business. And he had other investors that were in the car partnerships. Well, they lost all their money and sunk it into the Charlotte Motor Speedway. Bruton Smith then took the money, first time race ever, and took the money and ran with it. They were then forced to file for bankruptcy. Curtis Turner, one of the names to mention as well, who was also a great race car driver. Bruton Smith then, about 2 years later, was able to get the money invested back into the racetrack, and the rest is history. And Bruton Smith now owns great racetracks with Speedway Motorsports Incorporated, like Charlotte, Atlanta, Bristol, Texas, Infineon, Las Vegas, New Hampshire, and the list goes on and on, buddy.
Yeah, and what's funny about this track too, Wes, is that between the year 1960-1998, this track was known as Charlotte Motor Speedway. Then they changed the name very quickly to Lowe's Motor Speedway, and now we're back at Charlotte Motor Speedway. So just a couple of names there, former names that this track's been called, but it's back now to Charlotte Motor Speedway.
No doubt about it. And in just a couple of minutes, you're about to experience the excitement of the RSR Icebreaker Winter Series and the running of the Wounded Warrior Project 200, 130 laps around Charlotte Motor Speedway. By the way, just want to give you a little bit more background history on the track. The track is laid out of limestone bedrock, which delayed initial construction for over 2 years. Most of the track's shaping required dynamite, Michael Keaton, to blow up to carve it out of the bedrock. However, the limestone base, along with the seasonal weather changes, caused the track to resettle every year, and several bumps and dips over the track's path make it special and distinctive among the dog leg style intermediate tracks. And you see tracks like Atlanta and Texas copy the same scenario, the same, you know, design of what Charlotte Motor Speedway looks like, with the double dog leg on the front straightaway. As I believe we're getting ready to drop the green flag here at the opening ceremonies in just a minute, Michael.
Yeah, absolutely, Wes. And, you know, you talk about that dog leg there on the front stretch and how it could create some good side-by-side action. Dakota will probably have a little bit more on this later, but don't forget that grass right down there. You might see some left sides on that grass here tonight, and if that's the case, we could have a little bit of spinning out on the front stretch on this dog leg. So pay attention to the turns and that dog leg on the front stretch.
No doubt about it. And always, I'll tell you what, Dakota Ehrman, before we can throw it down for opening ceremonies, got to look out for the Humpty bumps around there. It's even though Humpy Wheeler has nothing to do with Charlotte Motor Speedway anymore, that nickname still stays true about those bumps in the racetrack. And no matter what they've done, in 2005, they resealed the track again. The ground settle forced the track to undergo a resurface, and it was done to a diamond cut to remove bumps and dips, but it just does not matter. You can't get rid of tradition, Dakota Ehrman, and those bumps still remaining. You'll see them in the broadcast tonight.
Yeah, they don't go away, but in the race car, you'll see that the drivers aren't going to really feel them a whole lot. It's going to be more about the cars are the way they're set up. They just don't feel the bumps, but you might see the cars jump around a little bit as they go around them there.
No doubt about it. And also, me and Michael Keaton will give you a rundown of how the points look as we get ready. But first, let's go down trackside to those Cactus Cuties for the national anthem and then the famous words in motorsports to get the Wounded Warrior Project 200 underway here on ETV Live Radio, powered by HD Radio Network at Charlotte Motor Speedway.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
ready to go here now as the field prepares for the Wounded Warrior Project 200 on ETV Live Radio, powered by HD Radio Network. Wesley Outland, Michael Keaton in the booth. Along trackside on pit road is Dakota Ehrman. Let's take a look at that starting lineup. We'll also give you a rundown of how the points look, because I'll tell you what, Chad Cole, John Abbott, it's those battles between them two drivers. Less than 35 points separate John Abbott from running down Chad Cole for the championship. But now let's give you the starting lineup. Qualified on the pole with a speed of 29.025 seconds. The 58 of Justin Wilson to his outside, the 46 of Randy Wells. Row two, Michael Keaton.
That brings up in the third spot, CJ LeVere in the four, and Chad Cole, your points leader, in fourth.
Now moving to row number three inside. It's going to be the number 82 of Terry Lane to his outside, the Navy Nukes in the house. And that 47, that's going to be Eric Arnold.
Matt LaCrosse in the 21 machine, going to roll off seventh tonight. Rich Jett to his outside in the 32.
Bobby Wetzel start ninth inside the number inside row number five in the number 19 machine Chevrolet to his outside. The Rhinestone Cowboy, Glenn Campbell, he'll start 10th in the 44.
The Silver Bullet, as some may like to call him, Dwayne Vincent in that sixth car, going to roll off 11th. John Abbott, who's in second points, trying to reel in Cole tonight, will roll off 12th.
And that's that battle we talked about with the points between John Abbott, 35 back, to Chad Cole, who starts fourth outside row two. Now moving to row number seven, John Milwayne in the double deuce, number 22, and Jonathan Cadell will start 14th.
15th belongs to Brian Harvey in the 67, and the man out of Puerto Rico, Jose Gonzalez, picks up 16th spot.
33 in the house, David Lanza in that Chevrolet to his outside on row number 9. To his outside, it'll be 18th starter Ed Williams Jr. in the ETV Live Radio 65 car.
19th belongs to Michael Gray in the 70s. To his outside, the 24, Mark Bratcher.
We now move to row number 11. Joey Katina will start 21st in the 14 machine. To his outside, Keldraz back in the 45.
Which was last week's winner at Talladega, West. And then Doug Roth in the 23 spot. 85 belongs to Nathan Bowers. He'll start 24th.
Row number 13, starting 25th, Doug Manning in the 51 to his outside. Number 12, Douglas Wyatt.
Mike Montesi, the first to not take time here tonight, is going to start off 27th. 28 belongs to the 88 machine of Adam Roberts.
Then it's going to be Wyatt Wolf Jr. in the 63. 30 of starter Angelo Cordino, Stephen Herring in the 98, and Guy Snyder, the 4th, will start 32nd. 32 starters ready to come to the green flag here at Charlotte Motor Speedway in the Wounded Warrior Project 200, underway on a Monday night with the RSR Icebreaker Winter Series. They dive into turn number one, the front row door-to-door off turn two.
Chilly night here in Charlotte Motor Speedway as the Real Sim Racing Icebreaker Series kicks off race number seven at Charlotte, as Justin Wilson picked up the pole and he maintains the lead west down the backstretch, but CJ LeVere is there about half a car length in three.
Yeah, well, you got Randy Wells on his back door. They'll go single file now for that number one and two spot. They'll exit out of the corner. We'll put one lap on the board here in the Wounded Warrior Project 200 at Charlotte Motor Speedway. LaVere sits in that number two spot now. He'll try to close in on Wilson's machine as they'll come to the line. Put another lap of the board as they exit off the backstretch.
These guys were very quick in practice with C.J. LaVere with a 29.05, Justin Wilson with a 29.05. So basically the same exact lap in practice, and they're showing here right now on the racetrack that they can run one and two collectively right here as they go down the front stretch completing lap two at Charlotte.
No doubt about it. Another pass for position going off of the third and fourth spot. Terry Lane under attack by Chad Cole, the points leader in the Hippies Paint Shop Chevrolet. He'll pull to the inside of Terry Lane, driving the retro colors of the great NASCAR champion Tim Richmond down the back straightaway as they go down into turn number three now. They're slicing, they're dicing all through the field, but for the moment, Wilson leads them in turn three.
Yeah, Wilson doing a fine job maintaining the lead. And then on back here, the fifth and sixth spot where we see Eric Arnold, the Navy machine, and Randy Wells West. A lot of single file racing here early on. We couldn't expect so much at Charlotte Motor Speedway. Dakota, some of these guys going to start mixing up here a little bit. But for now, it looks like a lot of single file racing, just getting the car under settlement.
Battle for about position right now. Terry Lane going back a little bit, but yeah, let me see single file for a little bit. Right now, they're just going to figure out what they're going to do. The longer they go, they're going to have to back up the corner. Some of these guys won't figure out how to do it or how to run the line.
Whoa,
correctly.
Terry Lane's car bounces off the outside wall in turn four. He loses four or five spots in that exchange. Dakota Ehrman, scary moment exiting off turn four, buddy.
Yeah, and there's another thing. When you come off some of these corners, I know at least in four, it's almost like you're going over a hill, and it's really scary. And if you hit that hill wrong, or what feels like a hill at least, you're going to go for a ride, and that's probably just about what happened to Terry there. But again, in the long run, these guys have to back up the corner a little bit more. It's not like they're backing it up right now, taking it easy. There's no point saving your tires. It's go pretty much from the get-go. The tire wear doesn't much matter here. What they got to really do is figure out how to drive it in the long run. That's a very tricky thing to do here.
We're still in the early going, less than six laps now here in the Wounded Warrior Project 200 on ETV Live Radio, powered by HD Radio Network from Charlotte Motor Speedway. Wilson, LaVere, Cole, Arnold, Wells, your top five. The man that gave up the third spot was that number 82 of Terry Lane. Bounced it off the front straightaway wall, entering the dogleg here at Charlotte. And now he has fallen all the way back as we got a great battle heating up for the number four spot. Man, I'll tell you what, Eric Arnold under attack big time by Randy Wells and company out of turn number two, Dakota. I'm sorry, Michael Keaton. I'm sorry, buddy. They're door-to-door going for that spot in turn number four.
Yeah, Eric Arnold right there on the high side that you see on board right now. He's got Randy Wells underneath him. Also, Matt LaCrosse in the 21 directly behind him for 6th and 7th spot. Bobby Wessel. That's Here Comes Bobby. If you've noticed in the Outlaw Truck Series on Thursday nights, Wes, Bobby's leading the points very, very strongly, and he's sitting 7th right now on this racetrack.
No doubt about it, as the green flag underway had a couple of scares there just a moment ago. Randy Wells and Eric Arnold, they still go at it door to door. That's going to allow Bobby Wetzel to close in, as well as that 21 to the inside of Matt LaCrosse. And here comes the Cobra, Dwayne Vincent of the Tabasco Hot Sauce number 6 Chevrolet. He'll now close into that battle. He'll hook up with the 21 of Matt LaCrosse. They'll come out of the corner, and that battle still heats up for that position, as now Randy Wells will break out in front in that pack down the back straightaway. But picking up your leader, Justin Wilson, he likes what he's seeing. Almost 200 second lead off the pack as they exit off of turn number four.
New second spot on the racetrack belongs to the number 8 machine, Hippies Paint Shop Chevrolet. Chad Cole taking second away from C.J. LaVere as they come out four. Now, what can Cole do? Justin Wilson's ahead in the 58, Wes.
Field comes back down the back straightaway. Chad Cole now closing in on Justin Wilson's machine. That 58 machine under attack as here comes the 8 down to the inside. The Hippies Paint Shop Chevrolet ready to close in on Justin Wilson for the point. But look out behind you, because C.J. LaVere ready to strike as well. That battle heats up again as they go to turn one.
Yeah, turn one, 1, 2, and 3. The front three leaders as Wilson gets the left sides on the bottom apron there. And here comes Cole out of two. Less than a half a car length behind. He's going to have the position in three, Wes.
And they in the field comes back out of the line. Wilson's machine now pulls to the outside lane. Here comes Cole. He's ready on the inside. Door to door at the stripe here at the dog leg. And that allows CJ LeBaire to close in ever so closer. More and more. Reeling him in. He'll go to the outside lane with Wilson. Three car battle for the lead off turn two. Michael Keaton.
Points leader Chad Cole led the last lap. He's still 2x2 with the Justin Wilson machine on the outside. There you see on screen. Wilson hanging tough on the outside as they go down into turn three. Cole on the bottom.
Cole on the outside now. Oh, excuse me, Wilson on the outside. Cole on the bottom. And here comes LeVere. Top Gun's in the house. Here comes Goose ready to support Maverick. Chad Cole is Maverick. LeVere is Goose. They're going to go out and door to door. Down into the corner, Wilson under attack. He's hung out to dry on the outside lane, but he will not back down. He'll hang with LeVere and Wilson on the outside by himself out of turn two.
Man, I tell you, CJ LeVere working that racing wheel there as Justin Wilson's on the outside, going to squeeze him down low there. LeVere's going to have to let off, and Wilson's going to maintain momentum coming off four as Cole takes the lead again and continues the lead here at Charlotte.
Well, as that battle continues between those three cars of Wilson, LeVere, and Cole, let's talk about the VRC MK2 virtual racing seat, a simulation racing cockpit designed by championship race car driver Bob Earl. Who better than a real race car driver to design a simulation racing cockpit? As a former race car driver, Bob Earl knows what it means to be comfortable in the cockpit of a car. The design features a fully adjustable seat and frame, additional monitor stand and shifter mount sold separately. Proud sponsor of the 2013 RSR Full Throttle Cup Series, a high-quality and affordable virtual racing cockpit is priced at low value of $349 plus shipping. See it all now at BobEarlRacing.com and order yours today. As green flag action still underway here at Charlotte Motor Speedway in the early going, you know, we mentioned about the point standings. Let's talk about that while they're still battling it out. Chad Cole is your points leader, 35 for John Abbott. Coming into tonight's event, Dwayne Vincent sitting third, 48 back. Terry Lane is in fourth, 59 back. Of course, Terry Lane got into the wall in that 82 car that we mentioned earlier in the race. Joey Katina sits in the top five, 66 back. Let's run him down the rest of the 10 to Michael Keaton.
Yeah, Eric Arnold sitting in sixth, with, in fact, on the racetrack right now in the top 10. Doug Roth, seventh at the point standings, 90 back. Nathan Little, just three back from Roth. And eighth, Rich Jett, ninth. And Kel Dresbach climbing into the top 10, 103 points behind Cole. Remember, Kel Dresbach won last week at Talladega in the Hippies Paint Shop, 88.
And it's 103 points differential from 10th to 1st. Chad Cole's opened up that margin by that much, so the man ready to strike is John Abbott. And the new leader, Chad Cole, the points leader, he's out in front. He's leading the way here at Charlotte right now.
Terry Lane.
Also, talk about Kel Dresbach and Adam Roberts, 105 back. They still got a chance to get into this championship hunt also, Michael.
Yeah, I mean, this is the seventh race of a 10-week short season, Wes. And, you know, Abbott's 35 points behind Cole. And some of these guys that is 100, I think they could still climb in. But Cole and Abbott and some of these other guys up top, they've got to have a bad week. And here in Charlotte, anything can happen. Wes, 2x2 racing for third, 2x2 racing for fourth and fifth with Dwayne Vincent, Justin Wilson, and Randy Wells at the start-finish line.
Oh, it's classic as the field comes back to the line. Here comes Randy Wells. He's going to deal with Wilson's machine on the outside lane. Meanwhile, LeVere is in that number two spot. He's ready to close it on your leader. Slim pickings for that, but here comes Dwayne Vincent in the number six car. He'll pick to the inside of Wilson. He'll carry Matt LaCrosse with him. They'll go to the inside of each other on Wells as they exit out of turn four.
Yeah, Dwayne Vincent sitting there in that fifth spot, Wes. He's all over the back door of Justin Wilson, who took us to the lead in green flag here tonight. As now the sixth looks underneath him in turn one. Might be a little bit of trouble going on Justin Wilson's machine. Dakota, is anything on the radio saying about concerns on tires on the right front of that 58 car?
Not exactly, guys. I think that he's just having trouble adapting to that new line. Like I said, the line, you have to really adjust to it, and it changes throughout the race. It's not like you have to take care of the tires here. You don't want to completely abuse them, for sure. But you got to be able to readjust that line. I think he's having a lot of trouble doing that right now, guys.
And no doubt about it, Michael Keaton, he is under attack, hot and heavy. Your 46 man in third, Randy Wells is. He has got Justin Wilson right on his crosshairs. One wrong slip, and it's going to cost. But I'll tell you something I've noticed. You've got Wells. He's under attack by Wilson, Vincent, and LaCrosse. And before we go to commercial break, here comes Vincent to the inside. I didn't want to go to break because I knew it was going to happen. Crossover move. Dwayne Vincent now makes his move on Wilson. He's got the whole shot on the inside, and now he'll close in on Randy Wells for third. Michael Keaton, he's coming.
Wow, and that allowed the 21 car, Matt LaCrosse, to close in big time to the back end of Justin M. Wilson's machine. Now Justin looks underneath the Vincent going into turn three. Vincent's going to have to stay high.
I wanted to go to commercial break. We got to thank our sponsors, but look at the great racing going on now. Wilson's on the inside of Vincent's machine. He'll pull to the bottom. Now comes Matt LaCrosse. Now they'll fan back out single file. LaCrosse now goes to the outside. He'll slide jump to the bottom of the racetrack. He'll try to make a move on Wilson's machine. Now they'll fan back out single file. And for the moment, Chad Cole out in front after that exciting couple of laps of racing we just called here on ATV Live Radio on the HD Radio Network. And by the way, Gary Mercer Truck, and if your pickup is too small for the load, get a real truck to haul it. Sponsoring drivers in several iRacing official series, Gary Mercer Trucking provides long and short haul options for hauling furniture, perishable items, and even refrigerated products and a whole lot more. They are CTPAT approved and Fast Express drivers. Gary Mercer Trucking is the best choice to haul your load, dude. Give the old pickup a rest. Call Gary Mercer Trucking toll free at 800-668-2980. And Gary Mercer Trucking will take us side by side. You're not going to miss a thing. We'll be right back with flag to flag coverage of the Wounded Warrior Project 200 from Charlotte Motor Speedway that you're watching on ATV Live and you're listening to on ATV Live Radio, powered by the HD Radio Network.
Huffman coming to a comfortable lead, coming out of two. He's got about eight car lengths, put it half a second over Dwayne Vincent as Chad Cole works the number two spot.
Time is running out. Vincent's got it. Cole wants it to the wall. Chevrolet puts the bumper to the 13 of Vincent. Vincent not backing down. He's in second. Gentlemen, we got one car on the bottom.
Hey, dude, are you ready to rock and roll? If that's cool, then you need to do it over at HD Radio Network. HD Radio Network, four stations broadcasting 24-7 with everything from metal favorites to the 80s classic rock like legendary Leonard Skinner, Electric Light Orchestra, Foreigner, and bone-rattling, skull-crushing rock and roll on hard-driving radio. Bear Factory, Stone Temple Pilots, Def Leppard, and a whole lot more. HDRadioNetwork.com. Take your pick and rock your brains out, dude.
Hey, JD here with ETV Live, and let me tell you something. If it's too big for the pickup truck and you need to move it, there's only one trucking company you need to call, and don't bother with the Yellow Pages, cowboy. I'll give you that number in a minute. Manufactured goods, automotive, technical equipment, furniture, even if you need a reefer, Gary Mercer Trucking Incorporated is the only choice, cowboy. With locations in Mississauga, Ontario, Canada, Rancho Cucamonga, California, if you need to move it, store it, and keep it cold, you need to call Gary Mercer Trucking Incorporated. Long haul, short haul, or just across town, Gary Mercer has the best trained and qualified drivers to get your load from point A to point B with professionalism and on time. So remember, Hoss, if it don't fit in a pickup truck, you're going to need a real truck, cowboy. Sponsors of ETV Live's Friday Night Showdown, Gary Mercer Trucking Incorporated, 1-800-668-2980.
Welcome back, ATV Live Radio, powered by HD Radio Network. Covers from the Wounded Warrior Project 200 from Charlotte Motor Speedway, the Mecca of Motorsports, located off of Interstate 85 in between Concord and Charlotte, North Carolina. Wesley Outland, Michael Keaton up in the booth. Dakota Irman on pit road running the boards in Indianapolis, Indiana. John Wesley and executive producer is J.D. Webb in California. And, of course, in the early going, Chad Cole is the man out in front. But we got a great battle going on for second spot. It's been that way, as you saw during our side-by-side commercial coverage. C.J. LeVere and Dwayne Vincent, no love lost between these guys. They're going at hot and heavy, Michael, in turn one.
Yeah, Dwayne Vincent's one of those guys trying to crack the top 10 here in points with this Monday Night Real Sim Racing Icebreaker Series. Again, this is just a 10-week short one. Wes, this is kind of like a build-up anticipation for the big thing coming up here on February 25th after the Daytona 500. These guys are going to take through a grueling 36-week race week.
No doubt about it. And again, that will be coming up on February the 25th, the day after the Great American Race, the 55th annual Daytona 500 on Fox. It gets into work for the race for that Bob Earl Racing Trophy, and the Bob Earl Racing seat is the trophy for 2013. Landon Huffman got it last year. Who's going to get it this year? It's the RSR Full Throttle Cup Series, and another one coming up inside Sim Racing, sponsoring the Asphalt Assault Series on Thursday night. Talk about that, though, Michael. It's going to be exciting. The RSR Ice Asphalt Assault Series Thursday night is going to be sponsored by Inside Sim Racing TV.
Oh, yeah. It's going to be another phenomenal series here with Real Sim Racing's the many of leagues that they have. Thursday night, 9:30 Eastern Standard Time, the Asphalt Assault Series. Trying to get confirmation on exactly what tracks they're going to be running at. I believe it's just going to be super speedway type tracks, but we'll get a little bit more information on the schedule.
Want to give you some information to the guys running in the back of the pack now about mid-pack. There's your 13th place machine, the number 14, Joey Katina. He's going at it pretty hot and heavy with a 22 of John Milwain. And another driver that we've mentioned in the last couple of weeks is getting it great going on, Michael Keaton, is Doug Roth in that retro color STP 43 car. Seems like the last couple of weeks, whether in the truck or the car, they have definitely been putting on a great job. Doug Roth ready to find victory lane, I believe, very soon. And I want to give you another shout out of some of the drivers we're mentioning onto the racetrack. Of course, talking about Doug Roth. Roth now trying to close in on Joey Katina as he just put the pass on John Milwain in 22 a moment ago. And driver sitting in 28th spot. Great looking machine. The Wounded Warrior Project, number 98. Normally he drives the Bojangles colors, not tonight. The Wounded Warrior Project, number 98 of Stephen Heron. We got trouble in 22nd spot. David Lance's car spins at the start-finish line. Cocks it sideways, about to put it in the grass. Not in the grass. He'll get it back in forward motion, and the yellow flag will go out for the first time on lap 37, Michael Keaton.
Also going to be involved in that is going to Angelo Corradino there coming off turn four. Wes, Angelo comes up ever so slightly into the left rear quarter panel of the 33 of Lanza. That sends the 49 of Angelo Corradino through the grass at Charlotte, bringing out the first caution.
Caution out as David Lanza's car goes into the grass just a little bit. Angelo Corradino also involved. They were coming. Here's a look at the replay. They were coming off of turn number four. Entering the dog leg, Lance's car to the outside, little contact made with the right rear, or the 49 of Corradino made contact with the left rear quarter panel of the 33 of David Lanza, and then they just pushed each other unison into the grass.
Almost kind of like perfect timing to West. These guys needing to come down pit road between lap 55 and 60. Some may try to hold it off till 65, but we're going to get some green or yellow flag pit stops here, much-needed pit stops.
Cole, Vincent, LeVere, LaCrosse, Wetzel, Wilson, Arnold, Wells, Cadell, and Jett all in the top 10, and then some on the pit road to Dakota Ehrman to call the stops.
Yeah, guys, one guy's staying out. He's going to try to get a bonus point. Doesn't look like it's going to work because it can have so many cars to get around. John Abbott was about 29th. Before that caution, he'll probably be further back because he got the pit around the second or third time around here, guys. But John Abbott in trouble and needs to make up some time on the track. But Chad Cole coming down, no changes to that machine, very happy with it. The first car here making changes will be Brandon Wilson he's not very happy with that car. He couldn't adjust that long run line, like I said, as we have the race off pit road. And I'm looking to see who won this. It looks like Chad Cole did get off first, guys.
So everybody runs onto pit road and rushes off, and they'll be behind John Abbott. And I gotta wonder, Michael Keaton, was that a good call for John to do that?
Well, you know, there's never a wrong call, I guess, at Charlotte Motor Speedway. This track here, Wes, you can kind of play around with a little bit. He might figure that in the next couple laps we may have another caution. Guys get fresh tires and some start to aggressively race, more aggressively. So we'll see here if it's a good car or not. We'll find out in the next 5, 10, 15 laps.
So here comes the field cycling back around the start finish line. It will be Chad Cole. In front will be John Abbott. Dwayne Vincent, C.J. LeVere, LaCrosse, Wetzel, loves the way they pitted. They'll see how they exit off at the scoring loop. And one to go. We'll go back to green next time. Bye, Michael Keaton.
Yeah, I was looking at that. I was thinking maybe Abbott was just up there to get that lap lead, and he was going to come down pit road this time, but not the case. The lights are off on the pace car, and Abbott's going to be forced, I guess, to stay out there, unless that was his choice, obviously. He's got a little bit of rear damage. I started to see that and start to kind of rectify my answer that he may have needed to come back down pit road, as Dakota mentioned out, that he is the second in points here. So this is a big deal at stake for John Abbott.
No doubt about it. And of course, if you're enjoying the excitement of the Monday night Real Sim Racing Icebreaker Winter Series, get ready on Thursday night, Sim Racing. And right now we've got the RSR Outlaw Truck Series, but coming up on the weekend after Speed Weeks of Daytona with the Full Throttle Cup Series is also a new Thursday night Real Sim Series, Asphalt Assault. Inside Sim Racing is sponsoring it, and they're your first and best choice for all news and reviews in online motorsports. Join Darren Ganchi and Sean Cole for this and greatest in-product reviews, simulation auto racing games for PCs for the Xbox crowd as well, from steering wheels to full-size racing rigs, updates on popular racing games, and a whole lot more. They are the yellow pages of online auto racing. Inside Sim Racing has it all. Visit them at isrtv.com. And we get ready to come back for the green flag. Pace cars in, green flag back in the air, and John Abbott leads him down into turn one.
Yeah, John Abbott got a really good start there. Chad Cole might have let up just a little bit on the restart to give Abbott a little bit of room there to go down low. As you see Abbott now going back deep down under the apron line there. Abbott's just, electrical issues on that machine, Dakota.
Yeah, guys, big time electrical issues. They cannot get the car to stay fired for some reason. He's just losing the engine. It seems like he's going to the back and is trying to get out of the way, see if they can get the problem sorted out on the track without pitting, guys.
And that gives the lead back to Chad Cole, C.J. LeVere, Dwayne Vincent, Eric Arnold, Matt LaCrosse, top five, the exit off two.
And Chad Cole is your points leader coming into tonight's event, race number 7 at Charlotte Motor Speedway, where John Abbott, we just seen him lead a lap. Now he's all the way back in 31st position. He's second in points, Wes. That's going to be a disastrous finish for him tonight.
No doubt about it. I do not want to interview that driver. Definitely, he's got to be in the mood. We got a battle going on for the lead. LeVere looking on Chad Cole for the spot in turn 1 and 2.
C.J. LeVere pulling the trigger, coming out of turn 2. Cole on the outside. Oh, he almost gets into the wall, Wes. I thought he was going to get a little piece of it.
LeVere will not be denied to the inside, and now cutting him off will be Chad Cole with the crossover block to the bottom of the racetrack. Cole, LeVere, Vincent, all throw them under a clip with one another. You can throw a blanket over the pack as they go into turn number 1 and 2. LeVere now under attack by Dwayne Vincent for second spot. He's in third. They go at it. Meanwhile, more great racing going on in the back of the pack for 13th. Doug Roth trying to close in on the winner last week. Kale Dress back. Now they'll go single file, and they'll try to get by Jose Gonzalez, John Milwayne behind Roth as they go to turn 3.
Yeah, that is a good little battle there, trying to get into the top 10. Joey Gattina there holding on to that 10th spot right now, but Jose Gonzalez, the Don Q Rums of Puerto Rico Chevrolet, trying to crack his Chevrolet into the top 10. But Kale Dresbach, as you mentioned last week at Talladega, putting on a show, Wes. He's got Doug Roth in the new colors there, the gold and black looking machine there as he rides behind Dresbach.
No doubt about it, as the field now comes single file back into turn number three. That's that battle we mentioned for 13th spot. Milwayne also in that mix. And let's talk about another battle that's heating up. Look on the outside lane. Adam Roberts, the 88, is the end of the dogleg. 63 to the bottom. That's going to be Wyatt Wolf Jr. He's going to carry Randy Wells with him. Randy Wells now going to hook up with Wyatt Wolf on the bottom of the racetrack to get by Adam Roberts. And here comes that ETV Live Radio 65, Ed Williams Jr. He's coming through the pack also. And hey, Ed Williams Jr., he knows how to get around here at Charlotte.
Yeah, he does. He's sitting here being patient right now. He's got Adam Roberts ahead of him. This is a good battle here for the top 17 as Wyatt Wolf Jr. leads that pack coming off turn four. Randy Wells in the mix. Adam Roberts, as you mentioned, and that shiny-looking red and black ETV Chevrolet coming in one.
So we'll pick up the battle for the lead again, because now it's down to three cars. Cole, LeVere, and Vincent now up to one another's back door panel. Arnold and Wilson sitting in fourth and fifth, and I think they're just kind of playing strategy with one another right now. And now, here we go. Wilson on the inside of Eric Arnold. Arnold on the outside lane. He'll now move to fourth spot. They'll go single file. Wow, Vincent got a little loose there exiting off turn one, Michael.
Yeah, Vincent's sitting right there, Wes, waiting to strike. You like to call him the Cobra. He's sitting there in third. He's got C.J. LeVere in that white-looking blue Chevrolet ahead of him. And then, of course, Chad Cole, points leader and leader right now at Charlotte. As Dwayne Vincent now closes within a half a car length behind LeVere as they come off four. Vincent's got momentum, looks to the inside. No, nothing's there.
Dakota Ehrman, what are they saying about John Abbott's car on pit road? Is he done for, buddy?
Still don't know quite for sure. Yeah, it looks like he's still having big time electrical problems.
We got a car smoking! Somebody's smoking, that's all I know. Somebody is smoking. Who we got? We got trouble on the racetrack. Number 26, Jonathan Goodell, giving up the eighth position after he spins. All I saw was smoke, Michael Keaton, and the caution flags out for the second time.
Yeah, this one's going to be in the 8th spot where Joey Katina and that 14 Home Depot Chevrolet is going to get into the left rear quarter panel just ever so slightly. We saw Katina try to back out of the throttle, but Wes, it was just a little bit too late. Rich Jett also caught up in the mayhem.
But could you call that contact with Katina's car? It looked like maybe Cadell and Katina just cut the air off between one another, and it caused that, made it look like there was contact, but they just simply, you know, broke the air and it made him lose control.
Yeah, certainly could be a possibility there. Really close, I mean, inches apart, Wes, and that's how Charlotte is. I mean, these turns are set up that way where there's multiple groove racetrack, both of them going maybe for the same piece of real estate. And just an unfortunate event where Rich Jett and some of these other guys caught up into it a little bit as we see John Abbott pull that machine behind the garage area. Wes, bad night for him as the leaders come down pit road.
Back down to pit road, Dakota Ehrman. We'll investigate this Cadell-Katina incident after that break. Go ahead. Cole staying on the pit road. Dakota, go ahead.
Yeah, guys, I'm wondering, Chad Cole staying out, thinking there's not many laps on the tires, so he's staying out, Rich Jett following him. As well as John Milwayne and a few other guys. But looking back here, Randy Wells and a lot of the other guys coming down, maybe I believe that was Doug Manning taking two tires coming from the 14th position. So there's going to be a bunch of tire strategy here, looks like, that could shake this race up here, guys.
Wes, looks like 64, lap 64 was when these guys last pitted. And so we're on about, what, 80, 81? So it's been about 20 laps, nearly 20 laps, 15, 20 laps.
And I'll tell you something else, too, while you're looking at that. I'm looking at the replay between Jonathan Goodell and Joey Katina. And it doesn't look like there was any contact between them. It just looked like Cadell came down, broke the air between the draft on those two cars, and around they went. Or around Cadell went.
I got to fix this. I was reading off Chad Cole's practice laps. He had a 15-lap run there, but we're on about a 10-lap run, as Dakota mentioned. Not many laps off that at all. Lap 40 was when we were under caution this last time, Wes. So 10 laps, you know, right. Now, did Cole use up the right front during any of that racing is going to be the question.
Dakota, what are they saying on pit road about Colt's car and the tires?
Again, it's like I said earlier, they don't think they're too concerned on the tires. They'll be a little slow at the start, possibly, but it won't be too bad with all the cars they have behind them on a zero or two tires, so they think they're in good position trying to keep their track position right now, guys.
So the caution lights are off on the pace car, the first Ford Mustang race pace car, and, well, actually the lights are flashing, but the pace car lights are off. There we go. It looks like they might be coming to one to go next time by. Yes, well, you're still under the yellow flag. Chad Cole, John Milwayne. Milwayne's got a shot for the restart, sitting in second, Michael Keaton. And yeah, so look, is Bobby Wetzel. Here comes Bobby again.
I was about to say, look who's sitting there in third, Bobby. Bobby Wetzel, who's leading the truck series, the RSR Outlaw Truck Series that you can catch on Thursday nights here live on ETV Live. And John Milwayne, as you mentioned, going to start this restart on the outside of Cole, who's sitting in the points lead right now. And John Abbott, I mentioned during the caution there, he pulled that machine behind the garage area, sitting dead last on the racetrack, 31st position, five laps down. Electrical issues for him tonight. He may or may not be able to get back into this one. But Mark Bratcher, 30th, four laps down. Jonathan Cadell, he was involved with this last incident. West, it was smoke pouring from that machine, sitting back in 29th, two laps down. So only 28 drivers on the lead lap.
And pace car lights are now off. We'll get ready for the restart. And I'll tell you what, how about we crank it up for him?
Yeah, do a little ATV crank it up on this next restart, West. Get these guys pumping the stereo systems.
No doubt about it. Should be exciting. Chad Cole, John Milwayne on the front row, Bobby Wetzel, CJ LeVere, row two, Dwayne Vincent, Justin Wilson, row number three, Eric Arnold, Adam Roberts, Matt LaCrosse, Glenn Campbell, rounding out your top 10 for the moment. As I'll tell you what, we get ready to crank it up, and this is going to be presented by Fast Track Weekly Live. It's about the nation's first premier pro dirt late model series in the country, hosted by yours truly, Wesley Outland. Produced weekly by ETV Live Radio on the HD Radio Network. Join us Tuesday night at 7 o'clock. Celebrate a decade of speed. 10-year anniversary in 2013 with the latest and greatest news from the Fast Track Racing Series. Driver interviews and much more. ETV Live Radio and HD Radio Network. And it's Fast Track Weekly Live. And they're going to crank it up for you here in just a moment. Tune in tomorrow night, 7 o'clock Eastern. It is the final show, Michael Keaton, before we pack it up and go to East Bay in Florida for the Winter Nationals.
What an event that's going to be, Wes. Looking forward to that event for sure.
No doubt about it. Pace car drops on the pit road. Green flag. Crank it up, ETV Lifestyle, for you here on HD Radio Network. You can hear the thunder of the cars as they go into turn one. The sight sounds of ETV Live Radio here from Charlotte Motor Speedway. Wow, look at this. Adam Roberts in the 88. And he is the driver in 8th position now, trying to battle with the 44 of Glenn Campbell and the 45 of Kel Dresbach. That's great racing on the racetrack. And look out, the Kohler Engineering number 20 of Mike Montesi, also in front of Adam Roberts' machine. They're trying to close in on each other as they exit off the back straightaway going to turn number three this time by.
Yeah, I'm going to tell you, Mike Tessie has got a back end full of the 44 of Glenn Campbell on the racetrack right now, Wes. I'm bumping each other in the turns. Campbell now drifts up out of four, allowing Roberts in the 88 to sneak underneath him and maybe give him a tap on the front stretch.
Want to give a plug to Ed Williams Jr., our ETV Live Radio car Chevrolet. He is in the 65. He's currently in 19th spot, 3.9 seconds behind the leader. And again, I'm wondering, is he just playing, taking it easy right now? Because normally he does do fairly well at Charlotte Motor Speedway, Michael Keaton.
Yeah, these guys, you know, you got to think, just come off of a caution, got fresh tires, wanting not to wear them out too quickly, so being a little bit cautious here maybe early on, letting the tires come to him, let the car settle in, run his game, run his rhythm, and then you'll see him come through.
Jose Gonzalez now has Kel Dress back to his outside, Randy Wells, Terry Lane, as they exited the turn three, and... That's for the 13th spot as they come to the line. Randy Wells now trying to make a move on Dressback's car. Dressback coming off that momentum of that win last Monday night. Do you think that can be a momentum booster for him winning at Talladega?
Oh, certainly, Wells. Not only did he win, you know, he cracked the top 10. That's the first win of the season so far for him. He's gotten two top fives already on the day for him. But, you know, cracking the top 10, coming off of a win, you know, here tonight at Charlotte could be big time for him. He's sitting there in 14th spot. All he needs is to plug away, keep plugging away. We're almost halfway, so if he can keep charging towards the front, Wes, he can have a really good night here tonight.
No doubt about it, and the question is, who is going to be the iLeagueRace.com Halfway Award winner? Working lap 65 will be the halfway mark, and again, iLeagueRace.com presenting the halfway mark, a one-stop shop for iRacing leagues looking for total websites and points management, custom scoring protocols, complete scheduling and management of series and events, even a blog setup to recap your race. iLeague Race also provides driver and team signups with integration and APIs such as scoring tickers and points updates with a lot more. If you have an iRacing league, you need iLeague Race. www.iLeagueRace.com. Proud sponsor of Halfway, as that is coming up in less than three laps. CJ Lavera leads on off turn four.
Tell you what, Wes, looking at the battle for, I guess you could say, a top four position here, Justin Wilson and Bobby Wessel, they've been side by side as Vincent now charges towards the lead. These guys back here, though, Wes, been side by side for a couple of laps.
No doubt about it. Here comes Vincent. Here comes the Cobra on the inside of LeVere, ready to do the victory of the spoils before the halfway mark. Vincent now, door-to-door with your leader into turn three, door-to-door in turn four, door-to-door entering the dogleg. Here comes Chad Cole. He'll play wingman with Vincent, but LeVere will lead that lap. One to halfway. They're back in turn one.
Yeah, Chad Cole's probably sitting there behind the wheel right now saying, man, I love this, guys. Keep racing. Keep running those right fronts off as Chad Cole sits there almost like a little patient kid in a candy store waiting on them, Wes, to wreck each other.
And one lap, he'll go to the inside lane. Then he'll go to the outside lane and hook with LeVere. LeVere's car wiggles a little bit in turn three, exiting off the center of the corner. Here comes Vincent. That's the opening he need at the stripe halfway. Who's it going to be? It's LeVere on the outside lane. He'll be the iLeagueRace.com halfway leader. 65 down, 65 to go. And it's LeVere leading him over Vincent and Cole. Top three off turn two.
Chad Cole all over the back rear deck lid of the 6 of Dwayne Vincent going down the back stretch. Cole gives him a little tap. The 6 of Vincent moves closer and closer to LeVere in 3. Chad Cole, meanwhile, about a car length behind.
Meanwhile, let's get antsy for 9th spot. Adam Roberts has got it. He's trying to get around the 20 of Mike Montesi and the 47 of Eric Arnold. He'll now make short pickings of Arnold's machine. No, he won't. Arnold back to the inside. He'll close in on Montesi in the 20. That's for, 8th through 11th, because Doug Roth now sticks his nose in the gunfight. And don't look out behind you, guys. 45, Kale Dressback. He's coming. They're going to go too wide into the corner. You can't do that here in Charlotte. Roth has got to back off. He might get into Roberts on the outside. They'll go at it door to door, back to the line. And what great racing we had just a moment there. The David Nuke now clears those two cars. Now he makes a slide job to the inside of Montesi in one.
Did you see that? The 43, Doug Roth, first time tonight, putting the left sides on the grass down the trial, as we mentioned before the broadcast started, the dogleg here at Charlotte. Somebody's going to get the grass. Roth did. Here comes the 88. Roberts in turn three, back underneath Roth.
And they'll go at it again, and that allowed the 45, a Talladega winner last week, Doug Roth, to close, Kel Dressback to close in, and also Randy Wells in the 46. They're in that battle. Jose Gonzalez in the 11. Some names we don't normally mention. Up into the mix, inside the top 10, outside the top 10, and it's still a lot of racing left to go as we just passed halfway.
Wes, I'm going to say something here. There's 25 drivers on this racetrack that can get a top 10. Well, guess what? Only 10 get it. And we are, as we see the 43 Roth into the wall on the outside corner there at turn four. Cars on the inside grass there as Roth stabilizes the car back in one. Oh, what a save.
Car hits the goes to the grass, hits the wall. He collects Randy Wells. Wells' car gives out a shower of sparks back into the corner. And wow, you want to talk about a scary moment for the retro STP colors and stroker race. Doug Roth, that could have been nasty. He'll still keep into the gas, but he did lose a little bit of momentum to that pack as they exit off turn four.
Yeah, a couple of spots there lost, and still the battle wages on for ninth position with Mike Montesi. Adam Roberts now cracking into the ninth spot. The 20's up high. Not going to let loose here coming off two, though, Wes. Good battle here for ninth.
I want to mention another car, the 82 Folgers Coffee Toyota of Terry Lane, driving the retro colors of NASCAR champion of Tim Richmond. Tim, of course, there's the Tag Heuer entry. The Camry got into the wall in the early going. Right now, he's on the lead lap, and he sits in 15th spot, and he's got a great wingman to help him draft to the front in Kel Dressback. Can they make it happen? As now they're about to make a move on 13th place machine, Doug Roth, on the backstretch.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. You know, Terry Lane qualified fifth for tonight's event at Charlotte Motor Speedway, Wes, and here he is 15th. He's just back there, possibly just giving a little bit of time, letting these other guys wear the tires off. But again, 25 drivers on this racetrack, or even more, all have the potential chance to get a top 10 here. All these guys are fast. This is what we're seeing, some good two-wide racing at Charlotte.
Charlotte Motor Speed is the place. The Icebreaker Winter Series is the race, and it's the Wounded Warrior Project 200. And let's talk about the Pit Report, an engaging talk show about everything and anything, sim racing and more. Josh Gerlach and Kyle Taraska bring you lively debates and interviews, keeping it upbeat and energetic with fan interaction and call-ins as well. The Pit Report, heard weekly every Thursday from 7:30 to 8:30, right before the Asphalt Assault and the RSR Outlaw Truck Series on ETV Live Radio, powered by HD Radio Network. Get the mobile app on iTunes Radio, TuneIn Radio, Windows Media Guide, and on etv-eplay.net. And by the way, you're tuned in to ET Live Radio, powered by HD Radio Network. They feature classic rock every hour, on the hour, every day. You can also catch live events such as tonight's broadcast with RS Race Day Broadcast, Fast Track Weekly Live, and the Winter Is Better Sports Show, and much more from the booth, and listen to engaging talk shows as well. Replays are also available throughout the week. ETV Live Radio featured in the sports section of iTunes. Get the mobile app from TuneIn.com and look for us on Windows Media Guide, ETV Live Radio, on the HD Radio Network. Wow, talk about a new leader, the Cobra, Dwayne Vincent, out in front, but Chad Cole, he's trying to reel him in.
Oh yeah, Wes, he's finally there. CJ LeVere giving up the lead moments ago to Dwayne Vincent, and then to Chad Cole to take over second from him. And now Cole is about a half a car length there behind him, as these guys are really close to numbers on the racetrack as far as speed and time. Dakota?
Hey guys, Chad Cole was the fastest car on the track. It was not by much, but he was the fastest car on the track last time by. But the second fastest car is somebody you might not expect. He's just kind of creeped his way up to fifth position. I listened to him on the radio. He's just kind of saving his stuff right now. Matt LaCrosse, he's coming to the front, guys, and he was only at 1,000th off for the last time by.
No doubt about it, as Chad Cole gets a little wiggly off of turn two. That allowed him to lose some of that margin on the leader, Dwayne Vincent, as they'll come out of the corner. And, wow, tell you what, Vincent, Cole, LeVere, Wilson, LaCrosse, you mentioned him, he's in fifth. And Bobby Wetzel, Eric Arnold, Adam Roberts, Randy Wells, Jose Gonzalez, some guys in the top ten that we normally don't mention, Michael Keaton, they're getting their fame tonight.
Yeah, Charlotte's one of those tracks where it's almost like Talladega or Daytona. You know, anybody can run up, you know, for the most part, anybody can just run up front here. This is a great, great racetrack, Wes. The pavement is really nice here. The turns work really into your favor. Although, Dakota, you know, mentioned one of these turns coming out of turn four and the bumps going in one and two, of course. But You know, for a mile and a half racetrack, this is one of the best tracks on the circuit, other than Atlanta. I think Atlanta's got them all beat, but Charlotte, very, very fun track to drive.
No doubt about it. And one thing I want to talk about before we go to break is Calamity Corners. I'm going to tell you about three places of this racetrack that you got to look out for. Turns 1, turn 4, and the double dog leg. Turn 1 is a heavy bump going into the turn on the bottom groove, and it feels like you're falling off of a building. The chassis gets extremely light, and it can be difficult to make a pass there, and you can get spun around very easily. Turn number 4, all the way around the racetrack, ironically, the track flattens out severely from turn 4 into the dog leg front stretch, which places a lot of stress on the shock packages of these cars. Look to see cars pulling slide jobs and getting very loose here during times of the race. And of course, the dogleg. Side-by-side racing will greet these drivers trying to cut every piece of real estate they can off the dogleg. So expect to see some left side tires getting into the grass. We've talked about that. They'll drive through the grass through both ends of the front stretch. And the Calamity Corners are 1-4 and the front stretch double dog leg. That's what we got to watch out for here in the second half of this race, Michael Keaton, as we did in the first.
Yeah, and so far we've seen a little bit of that dog leg, double dog leg grass move where some guys on the bottom kind of maybe being forced down there, putting the left sides on the grass. But hey, get the dirt off the tire, get down there on the grass, get it cleaned off a little bit, get a little cooler. Some guys like to put that left front on there just to get a little cool. I'm not one of those guys, but there's all kinds of ways, Wes, to get around this racetrack.
No doubt about it. We're less than 50 laps to go here in the Wounded Warrior Project 200. 130 laps around Charlotte Motor Speedway. We'll take you side by side. You won't miss a coverage of the action at all. You're tuned in from Charlotte Motor Speedway to the RSR Icebreaker Winter Series and the Wounded Warrior Project 200 on ETV Live Radio, powered by the HD Radio Network. We'll be right back.
Huffman coming to a comfortable lead, coming out of two. He's got about 8 car lengths, put it half a second over Dwayne Vincent as Chad Cole works the number 2 spot.
Time is running out. Vincent's got it. Cole wants it to go off the Chevrolet. Puts the bumper to the 13 of Vincent. Vincent not backing down. He's in second. You know, and we got one car on the bottom.
InsideSimRacing.tv, the fastest show on the internet. Sim racing news and reviews since 2007, with new shows every week.
ATV Live Radio coverage here of iRacing action with the RSR Icebreaker Winter Series from Charlotte Motor Speedway, the Wounded Warrior Project 200, Wesley Outland, Michael Keaton, Dakota Ehrman on pit road. And tell you what, guys, it's Dwayne Vincent out in front coming down to the last 40 laps of this event. We'll throw it to Dakota and Michael Keaton, and I'll be back in just a moment.
And right now we're looking at battle for third here. CJ Levera, the 58 of Justin Wilson, trying to get by Rich Jett on the outside. They do. I thought Wilson was going to force a little bit of three wide there, but no, thought better of it. The 21, Matt LaCrosse is there, Dakota.
Yeah, it looks just about like 43 laps to go, I think. And again, I was talking about Matt LaCrosse saving the stuff. He's coming. He's right there in fifth position. He's right there on the heels. I think he might have something for him. We'll just have to wait and see here, Keaton.
Yeah, it seems that LaCrosse get up to Wilson, and Wilson will get up to LeVere, and they're just, no one can really make the pass on each other. So those three guys stuck in a little.
And how about Chad Cole all the way back in position on those old tires? He's still hanging on there right behind Wayne Vincent, not really losing much of a gap at all. As I look back last time by,
a little bit of three-way battle there.
And how about second place in point, 5 laps down, still John Abbott in 28th position. I mean, he's still 5 laps down after that connection issues, but he is back on the track and kind of pacing, about to go 6 laps down here.
Yeah, you're talking about a fighter. You know, John Abbott sitting there second points, 35 back from the leader, Dakota, and we thought John was going to pull it behind the wall, able to get back on the racetrack, just 5 laps down, Rich Jets one down, so he's got a potential to pass somebody else here for 27th position, but not the night that Abbott was probably looking for coming into the 7th race of the season. Only 10 races, 3 remaining tonight after tonight.
Absolutely not, especially getting that point. We have a battle for the lead. Here comes Chad Cole, dove underneath Dwayne Vincent through 3 and 4. Wasn't quite able to complete the pass. Here comes Dwayne Vincent back on the outside. Dwayne Vincent's going to be able to hold him down on the inside. Chad Cole can't keep the momentum and hold the car down and keep off of Dwayne Vincent. So Chad Cole's not going to be able to take over the spot, and it's going to fall back off of Dwayne Vincent here just a little bit.
Yeah, of course, Dwayneson with about 10 laps of better tires than Cole there, who sits in second. But Dakota, you know, only about a car length separates the two. We just saw Cole try to pass him for the lead, couldn't quite do it. But, you know, could we see a difference? You know, is this the difference between four fresh tires and no fresh tires?
I think it's a difference at all. I mean, it's really lined up, and you have to use the whole track, as some might say, to keep fast here. And as I look here, I don't know why Chad Cole couldn't complete the pass, but Matt LaCrosse having no problem getting around C.J. LeVere. He is now going to take over the third position. That was a battle for fourth, for third, but not quite anymore now, as Matt LaCrosse kind of motors on.
Yeah, and if you remember, Dakota, that C.J. LeVere was sitting in fifth, got by Randy Wells, and then he got by C.J. LeVere. So he's sitting there in third, good spot there, but Chad Cole and Dwayne Vincent continue to be the two men out front here, 93 laps into the books out of 130 in the Wounded Warrior Project 200, set for 130 laps at Charlotte.
Yeah, I'm curious to see what these guys can do, at least catching the leader wise, and what Chad Cole can do with Dwayne Vincent at least. And I'm wondering here, when the last time Chad Cole pit, it was about lap 38 or so. And the rest of the guys put it around lap 50, so they do have quite a few more laps on the tires and fuel than Chad Cole does, so he will have to come earlier, which we'll also sequence here.
Man, I tell you, these guys up front running very, very close lap times. And Dakota, Justin Wilson just now coming off pit road, so I believe that might have been a green flag scheduled pit stop for that crew. Wilson going down a lap. Remember, Wilson led a couple of laps early on. He started from the pole position. Now he's back up on the racing surface in 27th spot. So, are we seeing green flag scheduled pit stops here today?
I do believe so. I think it's time for the money stop. You're going to see a lot more guys start coming down, and they're just going to hit their marks and have their crew do their job exactly how it needs to be done.
C.J. LeVere, yeah, green flag stops now being underway. C.J. LeVere, who was running in the third spot or fourth spot, is now down on pit road. Dakota, all the way down towards the end of pit road. C.J. LeVere comes to a stop. Right side's going up on that car. I'm sure left sides will follow. C.J. LeVere, another guy coming down the pit road, though.
Yeah, it looks like he got caught on the right side just a little bit longer, and he probably wanted to there, but the left sides do go up and are down pretty quickly. Is really too quick. I'm wondering if they actually just dropped the jack and didn't actually change the tires on that Ford machine. It was so fast there, Keaton.
Now we gotta wonder, when's the 8 gonna pit? When's the 6 gonna pit? Dwayne Vincent, Chad Cole, 1 and 2 right now coming off 4. Not coming down this time.
But Dwayne Vincent, he can really stay out a lot longer than Chad Cole does, but here's the advantage Chad Cole has. He is forced to pit earlier. When you pit earlier, he's going to have so much more momentum when Dwayne Vincent's out there on old tires. If Dwayne stays out as long as he can, Chad's going to make a bunch of on-track time, and when Dwayne Vincent comes out, he'll be faster than Chad Cole, of course, but he'll have to run him all the way back down again. As we have a battle for the lead, here comes Chad Cole back on the inside. He's not able to do it. He's still getting pinched down there. He's not going to be able to clear Dwayne Vincent. They are side by side heading through the dogleg. Looks like Dwayne Vincent is still going to lead this lap.
Yeah, and, you know, I'm glad you brought that point up, Dakota. Chad Cole is on 10 more laps so he's going to have 10 less laps of fuel, I guess, if you will, than Vincent's machine has right now. So we know that Vincent can go 10 more laps, but the question is will he? Or will he pit with Cole to kind of sustain lap times here? Because don't you think, Dakota, with 10 laps or 5 laps, these guys can hot lap these cars?
Yeah, especially. And if you put Chad Cole out there as a caution on the speedway, that just changed.
Wow. That just changed everything.
And I believe that this was the 47 Eric Arnold, like you were saying there. Yeah, it looks like a 23rd position. He's 3 wide, gets kind of caught in the middle between the 20 and the 33. The 20 being, I'm not sure who the 20 is, for some reason, Mike Montesi and David Lanza in the 33, and just nowhere to go really for Eric Arnold, caught between the two there.
Yeah, I think if Eric had that one to do over, I don't think he probably would have just rolled out of the throttle there. That's just one of those deals, though. David Lanza is stuck on the outside, and of course, Eric Arnold trying to push it through the middle there within the 20 car. Mike Montesi there. Not much real estate there coming out of a turn at Charlotte.
Not much at all. And I'll tell you who has the worst luck right now is those guys that pitted already. They're a lap down, and they either have to stay out and get their lap back and stay on old tires while the leaders get new tires. Or, I mean, this is just going to shake everything up. Everything's changed, as we said before. Don't know what to expect now.
And some of the guys that you're talking about there, CJ LeVere, Mike Montesi showing a lap down. I was trying to look for Wilson, Justin Wilson. Okay, 2 laps down. So somehow another Justin Wilson, who's led about 15 to 20 laps here tonight, started on the pole, Dakota, has somehow another found himself 2 laps down. And he was one of those guys who come down pit road and pitted under the green flag condition.
I'm not quite sure what to tell you there, but Chad Cole came in with a car length lead over Dwayne Vincent. He's going to be close coming off pit road. Looks like Chad Cole's going to get up to speed and be able to hold off the lead coming off pit road. That was rather close there.
Yeah, race off pit road, ever so close. Chad Cole winning it, still being shown in first, but it's like you said, Dakota, will these guys stay out, get their lap back? Maybe one will get the lucky dog and get the wave around, but if they stay out, they're gonna be staying out on old tires. So, man, you gotta feel bad for the guys like CJ LeVere and some of these other guys who came down pit road a little early.
Yeah, you really do. And had that caution have flown a lap, Chad Cole would be a lap down. He had 0.2 gallons of fuel left. He was almost dry and had to come down probably that time, had the caution not come out. And I noticed he was in a hurry to get down pit road and get that fuel in the machine.
I don't see how in the world you would stay out with 0.2 gallons left. But Chad Cole, I tell you, getting it done, man, I tell you, that's a brave decision. But one that's going to pay off big time, because you're right. If he'd have came down pit road during that, then caution would have came out. He'd have been trapped. And then he would have been back there kind of in no man's land.
Yeah, probably wouldn't have messed him up. Being as he, I don't know that he would have went a lap down. He just from where he was pitting, he'd probably still be on the lead lap, and he'd probably come out with the lead, but he would be on a little bit older tires than the leaders there.
Looking back into the booth, West, working a caution here. We'll lap 103 out of 130. The Wounded Warrior Project 200. West, we just had a green flag pit stop, then we had a caution, trapped CJ LeVere down, and some other guys down. Now Chad Cole leads them.
No doubt about it, and the last thing I saw was the Navy Nuke Eric Arnold's car. It looks like he spun out in turn three, the cause of yellow, and a host of other cars as well, and definitely going to make it interesting with a 27-lap shootout.
Oh, yeah, no doubt about it, Wes. Looked like, you know, Mike Montesi there in the 20, then we had David Lanza there in the 33 on the outside, and Eric Arnold there pushing the button of three wide coming off of turn two, no room for it. But I tell you, you know, when you see an opening, you know, when you see that opening, you want to go for it. I can't blame you. Know, you see the hole, you want to go for it, and that's what happened. And I bet if Arnold had to do that one over again, Wes, he'd have just rolled out of the throttle and not forced that three wide.
And Michael Gray giving up the lead. He'll come to pit road. So Michael Gray at least having one lap of leading in the sun. Now he'll come to pit road, and Dakota Ehrman, what are they going to do on the pit stop on the 70 car?
Herring, four tires of fuel. We just, being as he's coming down now, he's not going to take any chances. Just as the right side should be going up momentarily, there they go. The crew goes around the right side of the car, putting the four tires on it, or the two tires on it. The right side drops, left side's coming up. The crew putting the left side tires on it. The car should drop, and he will be away, guys.
ATV Live Radio, powered by HD Radio Network, the leader in sim broadcasting here at Charlotte Motor Speedway. We're coming out of the shootout, less than 26 laps to go. It'll be a 25-lap dash here in the Wounded Warrior Project 200. Wesley Outland, Michael Keaton along topside up in the booth. Dakota Ehrman on pit road. John Wesley running the boards in Indianapolis, Indiana, the birthplace of speed. And, of course, California. Is J.D. Webb, our associate producer, executive producer. Associate producer is on pit road, Dakota Ehrman. I get confused sometimes, Michael Keaton. And he's Batman. and I'm the Joker.
Okay, you can call me an executive producer if you want it, guys.
No, I don't think J.D. Webb liked that too much. Here we go, guys. Ready for the restart. Pace car is in. 25 laps when they come in for the green flag. They enter the double dog leg. Pace car now ducks onto pit road. Chad Cole with a great jump on Dwayne Vincent on the restart. Man, Dwayne Vincent didn't even have a chance to get beside Cole for the restart. I wonder if they'll call that fair or not.
I think Dwayne Vincent might have been caught red-handed sleeping there as Adam Roberts now works underneath him. Here comes Matt LaCrosse from fourth spot, Wes. He now looks to the inside of Vincent trying to take advantage of that as Vincent puts on the old Tony Stewart block in turn three.
Dwayne Vincent trying to put the moves on Adam Roberts. Then you got Matt LaCrosse in the 21 car ready to make a move on Roberts' machine. And how about Jose Gonzalez? Well, they're in the grass. Vincent and Roberts door-to-door for second in turn number one.
Yep, that didn't take long. Vincent in a second. Adam Roberts now goes back to third. Here comes Matt LaCrosse in the 21 now, working his Chevrolet underneath the 33rd place machine of Roberts.
Jose Gonzalez with a great run in that number 11 car. Now closing in with the 21 of Matt LaCrosse and Adam Roberts, Dwayne Vincent. Now they slice and dice for position. Great battle going on for 8th and 9th spot. Look who's coming, Ed Williams Jr., the ETV Live machine. He's coming in that Impala, Michael Keaton.
Yeah, that's Brian Harvey there putting the move on Ed Williams Jr. down out of turn 2. Brian Harvey now secures 8th spot. Ed Williams Jr. back tonight. But good run for both of those guys as they are into the top 10.
Here comes Jose Gonzalez trying to make a move on Matt LaCrosse in the 21 machine. Also, Adam Roberts in that mix as they come back into the corner. Down into turn number 1 and 2. Chad Cole out in front. Still leads the way. Robert getting a little wiggle. Roberts getting a little sideways there a moment ago in front of Gonzalez and LaCrosse as he gets him loose again out of turn 4. Possibly a handling issue on Adam Roberts. What are they saying about the car, Dakota Ehrman, in the late rally?
He's been struggling all night, guys, and they just can't get it fixed for him right now. And I believe he is on two tires. He is on two tires because I remember him going from like 8th to 3rd off the pit road there, guys. So Matt LaCrosse is on four fresh tires, and right now he's struggling even more than he was before because he's in a group of guys with four tires. He wants to drive exactly how they are, and we have caution on the speedway, guys.
DJ LeVere, 13th spot, Wes. He brings it out.
Yes, you're right, LeVere. the nationwide number four car loops it around, and we're under caution one more time. He gives up a great race he had going for him, and now he falls back to 13th and a couple of more spots from there. And definitely nationwide, not on the side of C.J. LeVere as the caution falls for the fourth time.
C.J. LeVere taking a hard lick. Well, like he got up into the 12th car of Douglas White there, the Detroit Red Wing sporting logoed car there.
Okay, then, so the number 12 machine of Douglas Wyatt, and I understand also the 4 of C.J. LeVere getting turned in there. And Dakota Ehrman, we got a couple of guys coming to pit road, but nobody in the front. They're going to stay out. Ed Williams Jr. comes to pit road, though.
Yeah, with Ed Williams Jr. coming down, he's just been in the back all day and just coming out for four tires to hope that he can, those tires maybe pick up a little bit of ground, guys.
I'm sorry, a little on-air, announcer commentary off mic as we were discussing. Chad Cole, Dwayne Vincent, Adam Roberts is your top three. Matt LaCrosse, Jose Gonzalez, Kel Drasback is in sixth, followed by Bobby Wetzel, Brian Harvey, Doug Manning, and Douglas Wyatt. And Wyatt got into it with the machine of C.J. LeVere, but he still holds on to 12th spot, Michael Keaton. Anybody in the top 10 can win this race, and I do not say that by just saying it to announce it. It's the honest, prophetic truth. Anybody can win in the top 10, in the top 15 for that matter. It's time to put your cards on the table in this 19-lap shootout, or even less than that when we come for the restart.
I'm going to tell you something, Wes. There are some home run hitters just in the top 10 right now. You got Chad Cole, who's leading points. Dwayne Vincent, who's no stranger to victory lane, he's won three in a row in another series. Adam Roberts, every week we say Adam Roberts in the 88. Matt LaCrosse, a newcomer onto the Real Sim Racing League, he's showing potential. He's got potential. He's in fourth. He's got a car to beat. Jose Gonzalez, if he can have, you know, a break and have some good, luck. I guess Jose Gonzalez is sitting there in the top five. Kel Drasback just won last week at Talladega, West. Bobby Wetzel leading the Real Sim Racing Outlaw Truck Series on Thursday nights. So a lot of home run hitters here in the top 10 that can win it. You're exactly right.
Oh, shootout time. Dakota Ehrman, who do you think's going to win this thing, buddy? It's going to be about 18 laps or so for this restart. 17 for the green flag.
I think I've seen Chad Cole do all right for about two laps, and then he'll lose a spot for a few laps, and he'll get his long run mojo on, and he'll kind of come back. But I don't think there's enough laps for him to be able to hold off of Dwayne Vincent. I think Dwayne Vincent's really got the car to beat right now. He knows how to do it on a short run. This is about what this is with about 20 laps remaining, guys.
I believe Adam Roberts is going to be somebody to watch. I know that he's got that ill-handling race car, but I'm going to tell you what, you've got to be a race car driver. Two tires as well on Adam Roberts' car, but you have got to be one awesome driver to get it done. And Adam Roberts is currently showing that, even though he's got two tires compared to the four tires all these other drivers have, he is out there contending. He's racing hard, Michael Keaton. I think he'll be a threat when the checker flags fall, because even though he's got two fresh sides of rubber and everyone else has got four, when the caution flag falls like we have right now, it lets those tires cool off. And we've seen tire strategy decide races and victories before. It happened last Thursday night in the RSR Truck Series program.
Yeah, Wes, and you know, if I'm one of these drivers right now, you got to think too, man, that if you are the cause of the caution, then you will be given an EOL, and that means end of the longest line penalty, and you'll have to go to the tail end of the lead lap. So you've got to be careful, but you've also got to be aggressive. Now, it's hard to put those two words in the same sentence because they're so far apart in definition by what they mean. So, you know, what do you do, Wes? I mean, do you sit up here and, you know, you get a good top five, or do you go aggressively here towards the front at Chad Cole and Dwayne Vincent, who's on the front row? You know, I'd wreck my grandmother to win a race. You know, I mean, I'd wreck my grandmother to win a race.
Yeah.
But, you know, you will be given an EOL penalty. And I'm not sure about on the last lap how that works, but, you know, with 18 to go, 17 to go, aggressive driving can get you in the back just as quick as patient driving can. You cause the wreck, you're going back.
And I don't believe the yellow flags are done flying yet. I think it gets down to the shootout. We're going to have another yellow flag. Chad Cole, Dwayne Vincent, Adam Roberts, Matt LaCrosse, Jose Gonzalez. Let's crank it up for you. Restart with now less than 16 laps to go here on ATV Live Radio, powered by HD Radio Network. They're back to green. I was mentioning during the break, we're wrecking 19 machine, Bobby Wetzel. There goes Bobby, spins around down to the bottom of the racetrack. And the, yes sir, the caution flag comes out again. Other car involved, the Wounded Warrior Project 98 of Stephen Herring. And the yellow flag flies again. Looks like there's another car down to the bottom of the racetrack as well. Caution's out again, Michael Keaton, with less than 15 to go. And we knew it was going to happen.
Yep, absolutely. Bobby Wetzel in the 19 car, running sixth position, going into turn one. Lets off the throttle just a little bit to keep it low. 45 Kel Dressback gets in the back end of him just ever so slightly. Harvey doesn't let up. He goes through full throttle on the outside, and then the rest is history there. Although I don't think Wetzel's going to be sitting too bad, Wes. Just a little bit of cosmetic damage.
Have you even gone all the way back to where it started? This wreck started all the way in turn number one, into turn one. Watch the replay on your screen. 19 sideways. Dressback got into him. I think Keaton covered that. Then Brian Harvey had nowhere to go. He slams the outside wall. Harvey gets collected in it. Then everybody goes down to the bottom of the apron. Doug Roth just barely got squeezed by there. Stephen Herring got collected in that exchange. Yellow flag central for the fifth time here at Charlotte in the Wounded Warrior Project 200 for the Icebreaker Winter Series, Michael Keaton.
Yeah, Wes, if you keep watching after that wreck, you'll see Michael Gray in the 70 car. First off, the 12 car will come down all the way down to the bottom of the apron. That's Douglas White. And he will collect the 70 car. And, man, I tell you what. They're both those cars are going to be out. I mean, the 70 just killed the 12.
I am trying to find it. 43 Doug Roth also on the racetrack too. Oh wow. Oh, I didn't even see this part. This is when I mentioned Doug Roth just squeezing by. Literally, this is after they passed the 19 of Bobby Wetzel. Oh, the 12 just came right in on him and hit him big time. And that was the number 12 car of Douglas Wyatt, into the wall, ETV ticket ride, we call it, for both of those guys, man. Pirouetting down the backstretch at the bottom of the racetrack, definitely a 9.0 for them.
Yeah, 9.0, 8.5, 7.9. I tell you, Doug Roth took an ETV ticket ride. There's no doubt about it, Wes, that he took an ETV ticket ride, man. That car's done.
Oh, yeah, that went out live. Chad Cole, Adam Roberts, and here we go. I mentioned him, Adam Roberts. He's up to second, Michael Keaton. And don't count out Jose Gonzalez. Look at them. They put the smackdown on the Cobra.
Yeah. Oh, Gonzalez looks like he's going to be restarting third, which ain't a bad spot to start in. Then you got Vincent, who's going to be up there in fourth, stuck on the outside, possibly. Matt LaCrosse, fifth. Good spot for him. Drez back, last week's winner of the Hippies Paint Shop 88 at Talladega. Doug Manning, Terry Lane, Ed Williams Jr. cracking back into the top 10 in that ETV Live Chevrolet. And Mike Montesi rounding out the top 10.
Final pit road strategy with less than 12 laps to go. Now make it 11 laps to go. And Brian Harvey in the 67 car was given the end of lap penalty. Pit road we go. Dakota Ehrman, what's your final thoughts of this race as it's coming out of the wire, buddy?
Well, I had my eyes on Dwayne Vincent now. I believe he is sitting in the fourth position. I think he's too far back. It's got to be Chad Cole. He's got the track position. He's got the tires. And, you know, he knows how to get it done, man. He's the points leader by about 35 points, probably a lot more being John Abbott is now, I believe, as I look down here, 24th, five laps down. So he will extend his points even further. But Chad Cole, man, I'm telling you, he's probably the guy to beat right now.
Hey, what are they saying about Adam Roberts and Jose Gonzalez as we get one to go on the pace car?
A few of them are surprised by Jose Gonzalez, but everybody knows he can compete. He's a great competitor, and I know a lot of them were just kind of surprised to see him up there, but, you know, excited to see him up there and excited to see the racing. Adam Roberts, however, on two tires, he has his hands full. He's not very happy with the car, and the other spotters have been notified.
And that final update on Pit Road is presented by HD Radio Network, home of ETV Live Radio. H Hard Driving Radio Network gives you seven stations to choose from, including Big 80s Metal, all HDR Classics, all HDR Country, all 80s Adult Radio, and much more. Take your pick and rock your brains out, dude. HD Radio Network is featured on the iTunes section, Tuned In Radio, and listed on Windows Media Guide. Listen today from HDRadioNetwork.com or take it with you. Get the mobile app from TunedIn.com. And they also produce great shows on HD Radio Network, like all the race broadcasts on ETV Live Radio and productions like And the Winner Is, The Pit Report, and Fast Track Weekly Live. HD Radio Network, rock your brains out. A Hard Driving Radio Network, home of ETV Live Radio, and we appreciate them as we get ready for the restart. Wow. Tell you what, it's going to be an awesome one. ETV Live, the only choice in simulation racing broadcasting. Since 2008, ETV Live has pioneered over 600 shows to over 300,000 viewers. ETV Live has pioneered and engineered some of the best innovations in online auto sports broadcasting. The industry experts know it's ETV Live as the green flag goes back in the air, and we're about to have another great industry shutout, shootout finish as we're back to it again. Chad Cole leads them off turn two over Adam Roberts, Dwayne Vincent. We got a 3-5 car battle for second. One wrong move and we got trouble, Michael, in turn three.
Well, Jose Gonzalez is trying to get by Adam Roberts and Dwayne Vincent in the six. He's trying to on the outside as they touch coming out four. Three wide down the front stretch.
Oh, that could have been bad. That could have been real bad. Chad Cole loving it. He pulls away from the field. They go back into the corner. Jose Gonzalez, Adam Roberts, Dwayne Vincent's three cars. Second spot. Keldress back in the battle. They're off turn two.
Yeah, Chad Cole's all but checked out, loving it. The second and third place cars right now, Dwayne Vincent and Adam Roberts side by side. The 11 of Jose Gonzalez in fourth trying to close in as they're still two wide in four.
Door to door, Roberts and Vincent. Now here comes Gonzalez. Vincent, he goes to the grass just a little bit in the 11 of Gonzalez machine. Drez back, LaCrosse, they're all back in that mix. Caution, trouble, trouble on the racetrack. Number 12 spot machine, Doug Manning, has spun out in the start-finish line, and the caution flag is out over the racetrack. Doug Manning, the 51 car, he was in 12th spot, but we're still going to keep it green. No caution. Chad Cole leads him off turn number four. Now the yellow flag is out.
Yeah, that was Doug Manning and also taking out Ed Williams Jr. in the ETV Live car. Man, wrong place, wrong time for Ed.
Oh, no, Mr. Ed does it again. Tough break.
Yeah, very tough break.
Seven-lap shootout. Will we get this race restarted, Dakota Ehrman, or is this race going to go under yellow?
Guys, I do believe we'll have two or three lap shootout here. And I'm trying to go back to make sure you guys said Ed Williams Jr. was taken on. He was collected, but only a little bit of right front damage. I mean, he was hit pretty hard, but didn't didn't connect with the wall or didn't collect anybody else, so I think Ed Williams Jr. might be all right to continue, guys.
I didn't say that Eaton did.
I don't know what. I don't know, Dakota. He popped that 51 car on the left rear quarter panel pretty hard. You know,
about spinner damage here.
That's
really.
Right, Michael. Just stand your ground.
And then going from 11th and pitting, going all the way back to 14th. Whew.
There's not many left. I think that Ed Williams Jr. should be fine, guys. He should be fine.
I hope he does rebound, Wes.
Shootout time at Charlotte. As there you see contact between. Oh wow, Steven. Oh wow. Oh yeah. There we go. It started with Ed Williams Jr. and the 51. Doug Manning, they made contact, they lock horns, spinning unison into the double dog leg tribal grass. Manning's car goes a little bit further, and then he collects Stephen Herron in the 98 car. Wow, tough break for the Wounded Warrior Project Chevrolet. He got heavy damage, so it was a three-car incident. But now as it all settles in for the shootout, Chad Cole out in front, the points man, doing what he's got to do. And it looks like we will go another lap under caution, apparently, Michael Keaton. So it's going to be like a 5 or 4 lap shootout is what they're saying.
Yeah, and you know, you got to think if you're Chad Cole right now, Wes, getting out off to about a 15 car or two turns of a lead, you know, with the laps running down, you got to think now we're back under caution. Dwayne Vincent's going to be on the outside of me. We're going to all be stacked up again. Man. Adam Roberts going to restart third right behind Cole there. So a little bit of nerves probably working in that Cole machine right now.
Final commercial break, and it'll be a quickie. We'll come back for the shootout and the finish. It'll be a 5-lap dash. We don't want you to miss a thing. We'll throw in a couple of commercials and thank our sponsors and take you to the finish here from Charlotte Motor Speedway and the Wounded Warrior Project 200 on ETV Live Radio, powered by HD Radio Network. Shootout time, lights are off the pace car from Charlotte Motor Speedway. It's going to be a 4-lap shootout. What's 4 laps to go now? It'll be 3-lap shootout when they come for the restart. It is Chad Cole, Dwayne Vincent, Adam Roberts, Jose Gonzalez, Kel Drasback, your top five, Matt LaCrosse, Terry Lane, Mike Montesi, Angelo Corandino, and Bobby Wetzel. Some of these guys have been involved in accidents. They've came back and rallied through the field. And we are ready to go for a shootout for 3 laps. Hold your breath, Michael Keaton. We'll let you bring this field back to green.
Pace car coming out of turn 4. Chad Cole.
Go ahead.
Chad Cole getting the start here, which hopefully is the last time tonight. Dwayne Vitsen on the outside, Adam Roberts in third. Single foul coming to you in turn one, Wes.
Here we go, down into turn one. Vincent under attack by Adam Roberts. We were talking off mic during the break, and I said my pick's Adam Roberts to win this thing. He's just really played calm, cool, collective, the triple C's all night long. He now pulls to the inside. He'll have wingman Jose Gonzalez with them. At the stripe, here they come to the line, through the double dogleg, here at Charlotte Motor Speedway. Trans back, back about, gets into the wall, three laps to go. Cole leads him back into turn one. Vince on the inside for the lead, and the caution's out! This has totally changed the complexion of this race.
Bobby Wessel.
Bobby Wessel has hit the wall, the number 19 car spins out on the front straightaway. He gives up the 10th spot. I don't think they'll get this race restarted, Michael Keaton.
Nope, I believe that's going to do it unofficially. Chad Cole will be your winner. Of course, lap 128 out of 130. Yeah, Wes, this one's in the books.
And very disappointed because this was not the way I wanted this race to finish.
Yeah, I mean, Dwayne Vincent was there. Vincent was there, Wes. I mean, he was right there on the back door, Dakota.
Yeah, guys, I just, I'm looking at the stats here for points right now, and if I did the points right here, Chad Cole will walk away with a 54-point lead over Dwayne Vincent. Dwayne Vincent moving over John Abbott by 2 points here, guys, and John Abbott will be 56 points back right now. So I believe if Chad Cole has at least a top 10 finish next week, he has clinched the championship.
Why can't we do like NASCAR does in real life and stop the field in the backstretch? Let's have a cyber red flag to freeze the field and then go back at it again. These are just some of the things that just take the excitement out of this great race. It was an awesome race, Michael Keaton, and the yellow flag had to stop the excitement of what I think was going to be one awesome finish coming up.
Yeah, it would have been interesting if Cole could have held on because, Vincent was there. I thought during the break that I just... Oh! Adam Roberts!
Adam Roberts has got a problem!
Yeah. Firing the engine back up. Adam Roberts.
Is he out of the cut, Airman?
I don't think he's out of fuel, guys. I think he...
Whoa! He just bumped the 49 of Angelo Cordino! I want to know what that was about!
I believe in hockey terms, that's called throwing the gloves off, Wes.
And he might have Angelo Cordino coming back after him. No, he's staying in the back. Nonetheless, they'll come to the flag stand. Double checkers here in Charlotte. And it's going to be Chad Cole and that number 8 machine, the Chevrolet, going to victory lane under caution. Dwayne Vincent second, Adam Roberts third. But I got to wonder, is Adam Roberts going to get some type of a penalty, Michael Keaton?
Not real sure, Wes. He's back under in the grass again here in third spot. He doesn't look too happy. I mean, he's got third here. It's not a bad night, but he doesn't look happy.
I wonder what's going on between Adam and Angelo. We might need to find out a story on that of Dakota Ehrman.
I went back. That's what I was looking back at on my monitor here. I was rewinding the laps back some, and I don't ever see Cordino anywhere near him. Might be something from a teammate that happened, one of Adam Roberts' teammates or something. There we see Jose Gonzalez getting into the back end of Adam Roberts there going down the back stretch. Wonder what that's about. Some of this could be just a little bit of fun, with OS, so we can't read into it too much. But now the incident between Roberts and Cordino, there might be something a little to that maybe earlier on in the race that we didn't quite catch. But nonetheless, Roberts needs to keep his cool here. The triple C's, if you will, calm, cool, and collective, and get this one in third tonight.
No doubt about it. They'll come to the line this time by the checkered flag in the wind. For Chad Cole in that number 8 machine. He'll come to the flag stand. This race in the books. They were coming for the white flag last time by. And here comes Cole, Vincent, Roberts, checkered flag. Race in the books here at Charlotte Motor Speedway. And it was a very eventful event. Dakota Ehrman, your final thoughts on it as the field takes the checkers.
Actually, guys, I just wanted to clarify on the event between Adam Roberts and Angela Corradino. I was told that the spotters are going back and forth with messages between the drivers, and Angela and Adam just exchanging words and not polite words, and Adam deciding to just go back and just kind of teach a little lesson, I guess you might say.
What is it about, though? What's going on between them?
Not quite sure, guys. They were just kind of getting a little aggressive with each other over nothing, really. I guess it was a two-tire call. Maybe Angela was a little upset about it or something. I don't know exactly what got the whole feud started.
Well, I wish we could definitely be able to drag them in there. Let's get these two kids in there to play nice with one another. Adam Roberts is already going to be in there for a third-place interview. And also, definitely we could maybe try to find out Angelo Cordino's thoughts. But to victory lane we go. Chad Cole, winner at Charlotte. And what a crazy race tonight, buddy.
Yeah, for sure, man. That was a... I got unbelievably lucky there, actually. I was about to pit. For fuel, I had 2/10 of a gallon left when I finally did pit. Caution came out there and saved my butt right when I got past Dwayne there. I was trying to make his life a little bit more miserable when and pit there, hopefully throw him off a little bit. Say it about 8 laps or so left, more than I did because of that strategy, but it all worked out there. Fortunately, last 25 laps or so were caution filled, and that's just the way the cookie crumbles sometimes.
No doubt about it, and talk about holding off Dwayne Vincent and Adam Roberts and Jose Gonzalez and LaCrosse and Dresbach. You had a whole hundred's nest of cars coming after you there on that last restart.
Yeah, I'd only get my restart done, then seemed like caution come back out, so didn't have to fight too much with those guys.
And Chad, this is ETV Dakota, and I was just wondering, next week going in, if you have at least probably a top 10, you have clinched the championship, how does it make you feel, and does that change your preparations heading into next week?
I'm actually not 100% sure if I can make it next week, so might have to find a sub if I have one available. I know Greg Netherwood already subbed for me, so hopefully we get two per session here.
Michael, get your thoughts for Chad Cole for this. We finish up this interview.
Yeah, Chad, also run here tonight. As you mentioned, almost running out of fuel there during that run there with Vincent. What ran through your mind when you seen that caution? I mean, I know you're probably thinking, thank God that the caution just came out, or you would have been trapped like C.J. LeVere. Speaking of C.J., never being able to recover from that incident where he did get trapped down a lap and then finished all the way back into 21st. So different night for him, could have been a different night for you. It paid off, but what was your thoughts again on that?
Yeah, like I said, I was seriously just about to key my mic up, tell Dwayne I was going to pull down and pit there, and yeah, I was thanking my lucky stars right there when the caution did come out.
Now, I got a question. As the winner of this event, if this event had to have stayed green, or do you think that the RSR officials need to possibly look at implementing something that will keep races finishing under green flag, or do you like it? Well, obviously, you'd like it because you're first place and won, but what is your thoughts if you would have been in second or third and the caution fell and it froze the field like this?
Well, yeah, I have been on the other side of the coin before, being unable to get a pass done or get a position when cautions fall at the end of the race. And I mean, the guys at RSR, they're always thinking, so they'll get it figured out. They'll come up with some system. The system we have really isn't that terrible. So, I mean, it's just unfortunate that the races have to end that way, though.
No, and in their credit, I will say, Michael Keaton, that, we tried 3 times within 10 laps to get this race restarted again. So when you run out of laps, you run out of laps.
Yeah, that's what we ran into was just, the aggressiveness, I guess, of what it's like to be there, being able to win. I mean, we had a lot of home run hitters there in the top 10, top 5, that could have easily won. I mean, this is Charlotte Motor Speedway. Everybody wants to come here and win, just like they do week in, week out. And it worked out for Chad Cole. I believe, though, if they had that green flag run, Dwayne Vincent was there this time. I mean, he was within about a car length of Chad Cole. Cole could have held him off, but Cole, in the end, come out on top.
No doubt about it. And Chad Cole, real quickly, throw out your sponsors on your car, buddy, before we, you know, say sayonara to you and great job tonight.
Yeah, thanks, Wesley. I got to thank you guys, of course. You always do a fantastic job, ETV, doing the broadcast of these RSR races. And I need to thank Hippie Doug Wyatt for my paint job. If you visit hippiespaintshop.com, you can see he's got a gallery there of paint. He does wonderful work right now. If you saw my car tonight, that's just a little preview. It's really a great-looking car. So thanks to him.
No doubt about it. Chad Cole is your winner. And guys, I've been able to run down Angelo Cordino on his radio, in-car radio. Angelo, what happened between you and Adam Roberts after the cool-down lap under caution to the checker?
He stole my beer.
He stole your beer.
No, Adam's cool. We like to joke around. We've had our run-ins, but we're both from Detroit, and we like to mess around with each other.
So basically, it was just cutting up, having fun with one another, basically.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, nothing serious with Adam. He's a good guy.
Awesome. Cool deal. Well, that's the thoughts of Angelo Cordino. So, guys, we were both wrong. Obviously, there was something more to it. We thought there was something more to it than that, but it just turned out for them just being friendly, racing with one another. All right, so that's the thoughts of Chad Cole. Chad Cole, the winner at Charlotte Motor Speedway, and, of course, the update of what happened with Angelo Cordino and Adam Roberts was just good old friendly bumping at the end. We're going to take a quick commercial break. When we come back, we'll wrap it up with Adam Roberts and Dwayne Vincent in the ETV Live Radio post-race show here from Charlotte Motor Speedway. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back on HD Radio Network.
Landon Huffman coming to a comfortable lead, coming out of two. He's got about eight car lengths, put it half a second over Dwayne Vincent as Chad Cole works the number two spot.
Time is running out. Vincent's got it. Cole wants it in the wall. Chevrolet puts the bumper to the 13 of Vincent. Vincent not backing down. He's in second. And we got one car on the bottom.
Hey, dude, are you ready to rock and roll? If that's cool, then you need to do it over at HD Radio Network. HD Radio Network, four stations broadcasting 24-7 with everything from metal favorites to the 80s classic rock like legendary Lynyrd Skynyrd, Electric Light Orchestra, Foreigner, and bone-rattling, skull-crushing rock and roll on hard-driving radio. Bear Factory, Stone Temple Pilots, Def Leppard, and a whole lot more. HDRadioNetwork.com. Take your pick and rock your brains out, dude.
Welcome back to the post-race show here on ETV Live Radio, powered by the HD Radio Network, as the Icebreaker Winter Series is in the books from Charlotte Motor Speedway. In the Wounded Warrior Project 200, Wesley Outland, Michael Keaton up in the booth, Dakota Ehrman on pit road, and of course a great job by John Wesley and J.D. Webb, and Michael Keaton is now going to catch up with the second place finisher, Dwayne Vincent.
Yeah, Dwayne Vincent rolling off the grid 11th tonight. Dwayne, not probably where you wanted to start here tonight at Charlotte, but I tell you what, finishing second ain't too bad.
I'll take it, man. It was that was a tough race. It really, really was. The car was just so tight, man. But old Chad Cole put it on us again, man.
Two questions, Dwayne, and I want to take you to the first one here. Back before the caution came out on that long green flag run, you and Chad Cole were both up front. Chad Cole was on 10 laps. Or 9 laps older tires than you and a lot less fuel. Was your strategy, like it matters now, but was your strategy to stay out there as long as Cole did and pit with him, or were you going to go 10 extra laps after Cole pitted?
I was going to run until I had 2 laps left of fuel. I was going to stay out as long as I could. But yeah, I was wondering if him being lighter on fuel was helping him out, but he was still quick. I couldn't believe it.
and two to Wayne at towards the end of the race, or actually before the last caution came out. You had a good restart. You had good momentum going into the first turn there, turn one and turn two coming out of it. You were right there, I think, in position maybe to set up some sort of pass or maneuver to get by Cole. If it were to stay green, would you have gotten that Chevy by him?
Yeah, I'd have gave him hell, I'll put it that way. he hit the apron, it looked like, and he got a little bit squirrely, and I was like, okay, that's what I needed. And then the caution came out, I was like, damn. But I sure was going to try.
I hear you. And Dwayne, with that second place finish, you move up into second in the points, just past Abbott by 2 points. You've already got one win on the season, but Cole sitting there ahead, 53 up on you, 3 wins, 2 more than you already in the season. Are you kind of looking at this as a, you know, as an end season move into the February 25th, 2013 Full Throttle Cup Series?
Yeah, you know, hopefully we can carry some momentum into next year, into the Cup Series. But, yeah, Chad's on a roll, man. I don't think anybody's got anything for him, man, right now. He's really putting it to us.
All right, Dwayne, and we know you'd like to thank some sponsors, some guys that help you week in, week out, do this thing for you, man. Go ahead.
All right, buddy. I'd like to thank Red Ass Chassis Works, ETV, for everything you guys do. Y'all do a heck of a job. RSR for putting all this on. Bob Earl, I'm not sure if he's sponsoring this one or the next one, but he does a lot for us, and we appreciate it. Mom and Dad for watching, and my girlfriend Tess. Hope they enjoyed it.
Thank you. That was Dwayne Vincent, the number 6 Chevrolet, getting it home in second tonight, just behind Chad Cole, finishing under caution. Adam Roberts, the number 88 machine, making things a little exciting under the caution. Wes, who's standing by with your third place finisher, Mr. Roberts himself.
Yeah, no doubt about it, and I think we got a new nickname for Mr. Adam Roberts, and it's Triple C, Calm Cool Collective, until the end of that race. Adam, we talked to Angelo Cordino in the Pabst Blue Ribbon 49 car, and he said it was just a little friendly bump and bang there, congratulating you for third place. But what's your take on it, and a great run in that 88 car tonight?
Oh, yeah, just that little friendly bump. He was talking a little trash under caution there. Had to let him know where he was running as opposed to me for once, so...
The word trailer trash came out. Was that true that there was some trash talking going on and you just, you know, wanted to tell him, hey, buddy, I don't appreciate that, or what?
Oh, no, it was strictly friendly. We're from the same, around the same parts of Detroit, so there's no trailer nearby.
No doubt about it. So there's a trailer nearby, and they can go at it and fight if they need to. So it's just a pretty good battle there between Adam Roberts and Angelo Cordino. And I'll tell you what, Adam, man, what a great job you put on racing tonight, dude. I got to give you a commending. What an awesome performance coming through the field.
Oh, I greatly appreciate that, guys. I had fun tonight. You know, Chad always gives us something to strive for. I started almost dead last because I had a horrible qualifying effort, as usual. And I was lucky to get at least one decent green flag around to where I could put the wood down, so I greatly appreciate it.
No doubt about it, man. And how's it feel to have guys like you and Matt LaCrosse and Jose Gonzalez and just names that are normally in the back now getting up to the front and putting their names on for yourself?
Oh, I like it. You know, I think, you know, the whole... middle of the pack guys are starting to catch on how we race, and we're getting familiar with each other, and you know, maybe one of these days I'll be able to push the 6 by the 8. I'm pretty sure that's going to happen sooner or later, I promise you.
If the caution had not fell with 2 laps to go, do you think you would have been able to rally in there? Because you were my pick to win this race, dude.
Well, I appreciate your support. You know, Chad's always strong as usual. It's frustrating, but you know what? I mean... that he's got it down, but I think my plan was, if I was to start third again, you know, I mean, Dwayne passed me on the outside, I was going to, if he could get up underneath him, I was going to try and push him to the win, because I don't think I had it enough to get by both of them, so.
Thank out your sponsors, buddy.
Well, I just want to thank Bob Earl Racing. Seats, I think they're still a part of RSR. I want to thank RSR Racing, Real Sim Racing, for giving us the opportunity to race every week. Chad Cole for giving us something to aim for, and Jack Daniels for sponsoring my car week to week. And thank you guys for doing such a great job.
No doubt about it. And as we wrap it up here tonight from Charlotte Motor Speedway and get ready to pack it up and head on down there to Indianapolis, Indiana, the home of John Westland and the Brickyard 65 next Monday night. That's the third place finisher of Mr. Adam Roberts. And I really believe, Michael Keaton, give him about another couple of races, he'll be in victory lane pretty soon. Pretty soon.
No, yeah. Second loser.
What was that, Adam? What was that, buddy?
There will be no more second loser.
There will be no more second loser. Dwayne Vincent in second spot, the Cobra, and of course the man in victory lane coming out of the points lead over John Roberts. And of course this is just an overall boost for Chad Cole, because Michael Keaton, he had a 35 point lead over John Abbott coming into the race. Abbott has electrical issues, falls to the back, and now in doing so that allows him to open up that margin even more. And according to Dakota Ehrman, the stat guy as well, Greg Wood, letting us know probably later on tomorrow or this week, he needs to finish in the top 15 or better and he will clinch the Icebreaker Winter Series Championship. Final thoughts on the race, Michael, at Charlotte.
As always, you know, another great race that these guys put on towards the end. And, of course, you know, the beginning of this race was a lot of people in the chat during the race was talking about how the green flag racing was and how we probably wouldn't see a yellow. And I tell you what, if it wasn't 3 seconds after somebody said that, the yellow came out. I tell you, I can't wait until we get one of these green flag runs done to see how these guys come down pit road. We saw a little bit of it. We saw LeVere get caught up in that, and we can see how it can turn against you, and or it can turn for the good, as we saw Cole and Vincent pay off for them, you know. So it's always something different every week, and that's what I love about this RSR League. There's always a different winner. There's always a different guy up there, you know, turning the pipes, if you will, as we saw Roberts up there. I like Roberts' attitude, you know. I'll wreck my grandmother when we win a race.
No doubt about it, and I'll tell you what, in closing thoughts, what an awesome race. We'll pack it up here from Charlotte and get ready for Indianapolis Motor Speedway, the Brickyard 65, next Monday night, 9:30 Eastern, with a pre-race show here on ETV Live Radio, powered by HD Radio Network. And a big thanks to all of our sponsors for tonight's races to make it happen. Before we close it out with J.D. Webb, VRC, MK2, Virtual Racing Seat by Bob Earl Racing, and the winner is Motorsports Show, Gary Mercer Trucking, Inside Sim Racing TV, Fast Track Weekly Live. Tomorrow night, going to be a great show. Got guys like Ernie Shelton, Al Varnador from East Bay Raceway Park, Barry Braun from XSAN TV, and Jason Atkins from FlagToFlag.net. Definitely tune into that tomorrow night at 7 o'clock Eastern. And then, of course, also coming up tomorrow night will be ETV Live Team Racing Series programming. And, of course, all other great things, iLeagueRace.com, the Pit Report Weekly Show, ETV Live Radio, and HD Radio Network, the networks that you heard tonight's race on. So, it's been a good one. Wesley Outland along with Michael Keaton. It's been a great race. J.D. Webb, take us home as we'll pack our bags and get ready for Indy next Monday night. And by the way, don't forget about Talladega for the RSR Truck Series on Thursday night.
You bet. And I'll tell you, there's a whole lot more racing coming your way for 2013. We're gearing up and getting ready. You can join Chad, Dwayne, Adam, the whole crew here Monday night, 9:30, Real Sim Racing Full Throttle Cup Series, back in the saddle again, sponsored by Bob Earl Racing. Tuesday nights, 9 o'clock, ETV Live Team Racing Series. And I'll tell you something, if you haven't seen these team series, you haven't seen anything yet. Sponsored by the HD Radio Network, Jerry Wolf returns with the ETV Live Team Racing Series. Wednesday night, 7 o'clock p.m., Maritime iRacing League. Hey, if you haven't caught him yet, you need to tune in here on Wednesday nights at 7 p.m., ETV Live. Thursday nights, 9:30, Real Sim Racing Asphalt Assault Series, back in the saddle for the second time. Sponsored by Inside Sim Racing TV. And I'll tell you something, this is going to be the nationwide B car, and I'll tell you, these guys are tough. If you missed out on 2012 here at Real Sim Racing on the ETV Live Network, you really missed out some good racing. Friday nights, 8 o'clock, Super Speedway Cup Series. So we got a week's worth of racing for 2013 every night of the week here on ETV Live. And you can catch us at etv-eplay.net and on the ETV Live Radio on the tuneinradio.com. So with that, we'll catch you boys tomorrow night.
Oh,